Since they got elected, members of the Squad, the far-left progressive Democrats, have been accused of illegal activities, campaign finance violations, or other unethical acts. Recently, in a story from ProPublica, they talk about how Rashida Tlaib is stonewalling the Office for Congressional Ethics while they're investigating potential ethics violations. We have a story from last year about how Ocasio-Cortez may have illegally paid her boyfriend so he could move to New York to be with her, which brings me to today's story. In a shocking twist, Ilhan Omar has just come out and admitted a relationship with a man she was accused of illegally funneling money to. Now, that story between her and this guy is extremely complicated. There's, you know, the guy's wife coming out saying that he declared her love for Ilhan. Ilhan was accused of paying off her husband a large sum of money so he would stay quiet, denying the whole thing. And this plays into the ongoing scandal around Ilhan Omar's past campaign finance violations, but also whether or not she actually married her brother. This is just getting so, so strange that we actually have another big story about the far left Democrats. And to me, it is kind of shocking to see that these progressives would absolutely excuse this overt corruption if it meant getting rid of the Democratic establishment. Because for me, I wouldn't want to replace crony establishment elites with corrupt individuals who would probably do the exact same things. I mean, what Ilhan Omar is doing seems overt and obvious. In fact, she just comes out and posts a photo on Instagram saying, "Yup, we're married," after previously denying there was a relationship at all, lending credence to the idea that she was paying this guy through her campaign so he could travel around with her because they were having an affair. Now, the FBI is apparently looking into claims she married her brother. We'll see how far it goes, but this is just getting crazy. Let's get started with the latest news. Ilhan Omar announces marriage to Tim Mynett in Instagram post. Now, for most of you seeing that headline, you'd probably be like, "So what? Congratulations on getting married." This is the guy who divorced his wife. His wife claims that he was having an affair. This is the guy that Ilhan Omar was accused of illegally funneling money to. She denied the affair. And if there was no affair, there's no real motive for paying for this guy to travel around with her other than work. But if it's, as it turns out, they were legit in a relationship, which shows that it may actually be probable, nay, likely, that she was paying this guy to romp around with her. Let's read the story. Before we get started, head over to timcast.com/donate if you'd like to support my work. There are several ways you can give. However, the best thing you can do is just share this video. YouTube suppresses content like this. There's actually a lot of things I can't talk about right now showing you that, well, censorship is a big problem on YouTube. But if you do think these videos are good, please consider sharing them. But more importantly, many of you have not subscribed. And if you want to make sure you get these videos every day, because I post them every day at 4 p.m., subscribe, hit the notification bell. Otherwise, it may come to a point where YouTube just stops showing these videos. But let's read the first story from Fox News. Rep. Ilhan Omar shared some personal news Wednesday night. She's a new bride. Well, in that regard, congratulations. The Minnesota Democrat posted on Instagram a photo of herself and her former political consultant, Tim Mynett. "Got married. From partners in politics to life partners. So blessed. Alhamdulillah," she wrote in the caption, ending with the Arabic word that translates in English to "Praise be to God." Word of a romance between Omar Mynett became more than just talk last August when Mynett's then-wife, Beth Mynett, filed for divorce from her 38-year-old husband. In her court papers, Beth Mynett claimed her husband's traveling and work hours may have been more related to his affair with Omar than to his actual work commitments. The Mynett split was finalized in December. Beth and Tim Mynett are parents of a teenage son. Last October, Omar filed for divorce from her husband, Ahmed Hirsi, the father of their three children. "There has been an irretrievable breakdown of the marriage relationship," Omar claimed in court documents filed on her 30th birthday. Omar claimed neither partner was seeking an order of protection, and she asked the court to grant them joint legal and physical custody of their three minor children. The Omar-Hirsi divorce was finalized in November, according to the reports. Hirsi then found a new girlfriend and remarried just 37 days later in Somalia, the New York Post reported. Hirsi posted a photo of himself and a woman believed to be his new wife on Instagram in January. Quote, "I look forward to this new chapter in my life and I ask all of you to join me in celebration," he captioned the photo. But over on Ilhan Omar's Instagram, interestingly, there are many people cheering her on and saying congratulations. And, you know, look, if the story was just her getting married and finding happiness, I got no issue with that. Congratulations on finding someone you truly care about. And they look like they're very happy. The problem is campaign finance violation. Back in August, Ilhan Omar was hit with an FEC complaint accused of paying alleged paramour's travel expenses with campaign funds. As we now know, it's not an allegation that it's her paramour. They got married. She wanted to marry the guy. She really had no choice but to come out and say she did. But it's kind of shocking to me because now it lends credence to the idea that you wanted this guy to be flying around the country or whatever with you. So you were paying him to do so and it had nothing to do with campaigns. You cannot use campaign money for personal use. This is excellent evidence and circumstantial that she was doing just that. Let's read the story from Fox News. They say, the conservative Virginia-based National Legal and Policy Center filed a complaint against Rep. Ilhan Omar from Minnesota with the Federal Election Committee on Wednesday, alleging that the lawmaker used campaign funds to illegally reimburse her purported paramour for personal travel expenses. That's what the guy's wife was saying. Come on, man. Are we going to get an investigation into this? The guy's wife said he wasn't traveling for work. He was having an affair. This organization filed a complaint saying she was paying him because they were having an affair. Come on, man. That's enough, right? Start an investigation, dig into this. The complaint also charges that Omar failed to itemize travel reimbursements as required by the FEC Act, the Federal Election Campaign Act of 1971, and that the travel expenses increased during the same month that Omar's alleged affair with married Washington, D.C. political consultant Tim Mynett heated up. Come on. She's just come out and admitted the relationship. When the affair allegedly started, she began giving him more money. How obvious. The complaint was filed one day after it emerged that Beth Mynett, 55, submitted divorce papers in Washington, D.C. Superior Court, claiming her husband suddenly informed her earlier this year that he was having an affair with Omar. Omar has denied that she had an affair with Mynett, and her attorneys have dismissed the FEC complaint as a baseless political ploy. When asked on Tuesday by WCCO if she was separated from her own husband and if she was dating anyone, Omar replied, "No, I am not. As I said yesterday, I have no interest in really allowing the conversation about my personal life to continue, and so I have no desire to discuss it." Well, she also contradicted that by posting a photo saying she married a guy. If she did not want her personal life and her personal business and dirty laundry aired to the public, she shouldn't be posting that stuff. Omar's campaign paid Mynett's E Street Group LLC around $230,000 for fundraising consulting, digital communications, internet advertising, and travel expenses since 2018. Federal election records indicate most of those payments occurred after Election Day last year. 8 disbursements from Ilhan's campaign to the E Street Group for travel expenses totaling $21,546.94 were not itemized. FEC rules, the NLPC said, require that such travel expenses list the individual benefiting from the arrangement, as well as the date of the proposed and purpose of the payment. You got to tell them why they traveled. And apparently, she didn't itemize it. Could it be she did not have a legitimate reason for this man to fly with her? NLPC said that Omar's team instead only listed E Street as the payee and contained no details on the trips. Well, like Ilhan Omar said, she doesn't want her personal life to be aired out in the public, right? Although Mynett's formal relationship with Rep. Omar's campaign began July 2018, with the payment of $7,000 directly to Mynett, the reimbursements for Mynett's travel did not commence until April 2019, the same month that Dr. Mynett alleges in her filing that her husband told her of the affair and made a shocking declaration of love for Rep. Omar. They got married. Come on. We're looking back on this. Hindsight is 2020 now, I guess. It appears that Mynett's travel, as reported by Ilhan for Congress, may have been unrelated or only partially related to Omar's campaign. The complaint continued, noting that romantic companionship is not a legitimate reason to spend campaign funds on travel. And look, a lot of people might say that she would try to use a loophole like, oh, you can hire your girlfriend if you just, you know, claim a legitimate reason. No, human beings are not, well, for the most part, robots. If you try claiming this and they look at it, they're going to say, no. I've talked about finance with a lot of business people in terms of my business. You're not going to pull a fast one on the government investigations. They're going to say, why did this person travel with you? She'll make up a reason. Oh, he's a consultant. Consulting for what? Why? No, we don't buy it. You married the guy. Responding to the complaint, David Mitrani, counsel to Ilhan for Congress and the E Street Group, said in a statement that any accusation made that her clients acted to skirt the law in any way is absolutely false and completely unfounded. E Street Group provides multiple different services to Ilhan for Congress. Multiple different services. Hey, under an arm's length contract. Arm's length, huh? Fundraising, digital advertising, and the like. As a part of those services, the principals of E Street Group travel around the country fundraising for the congresswoman. There is nothing untoward about this, nor anything illegal about it. And the complaint even misstates the law on travel reimbursements, as it is not required for payments to vendors, only for payments specifically to individuals. Legal experts said the payments were not necessarily illegal because Omar's apparent personal connections to Mynett, as long as they were for bona fide campaign expenditures, which now may not be the case. And now with her admission, I personally think there's grounds to look into this. In June, Minnesota campaign finance officials found that Omar repeatedly violated state rules when she used campaign funds to pay for personal out-of-state travel, as well as help on her tax returns. Omar was ordered to reimburse her former campaign committee $3,500. She has a history of doing this. She's done it before. Come on, man. I can't believe so many progressives are standing behind her. You do not let these people just walk all over you. You will get nothing from me in complaining about the corruption of the crony establishment Democrats than ignoring what this woman is doing. Sorry, I'm not interested in that. The Minnesota Campaign Finance and Public Disclosure Board said the first-term congresswoman must pay the state a $500 civil penalty for using campaign money to travel to Florida, where she accepted an honorarium. You mean to tell me she's used campaign money for personal travel before? Come on. You following this one? Well, let's check this out. Let's move on. The Daily Mail reported earlier last month, mid last month, Ilhan Omar's husband discovered she was cheating on him with her chief fundraiser when he walked in on the lovers in pajamas. And now the congresswoman is paying the ex $250,000 for his silence. This was reported as a statement of fact by the Daily Mail. She did this. No complaints, no lawsuits. No demands for attraction, as far as I can tell. This is them saying, Ahmed Hirsi discovered that they were having an affair, and now she's paying him. Check this out. Ahmed Hirsi had long suspected Omar was cheating on him with married Tim Mynett, but the proof came when he caught the hijab-wearing congresswoman in a state that no Muslim woman would expect to be with a man who is not her husband. Two separate sources confirmed the account to Daily Mail, saying that Hirsi was left angry and humiliated. He suspected she was cheating, but she kept telling him he was paranoid. No, let me stop for a second. And I'll move on from this because I do want to talk about Rashida Tlaib and actual ethics violations. Many people are probably saying, I don't care about the affair. You know, people are going to cheat their personal lives. The issue is not the affair. The issue is Ilhan Omar has violated campaign finance laws in the past. She's been accused of doing so now. She denied the relationship at the time, saying it was professional. And now we know they were cheating. And if that's true, it stands to reason these were illegal payments. So they go on to say, apparently this guy's getting a fat paycheck. Let me see, where we go. The sources say the families of Hirsi and Omar hammered out a financial settlement that would give Hirsi tens of thousands of dollars over several years, but only if he did not speak publicly about the marriage breakdown. One source said the figure was as high as $250,000 over 6 years. Hirsi did not return at DailyMail.com requests for comments. Soon after the agreement was reached last year, Hirsi, 40, traded in his old Nissan Maxima for a BMW 528i, which sells for $54,000 new. Are you kidding me? These people are swimming in a cesspool of corruption. And you know what? There are so many people who would excuse it. Now, also recently, just towards the end of last year, a member of the Somali community, apparently in Minnesota, said Omar did marry her brother, and it was essentially to bypass immigration laws to speed things up and bring him here. And look, man, I got to say at this point, I think it's true. That's just my opinion. But look, you got these stories definitively reported, witnesses saying this stuff. Check this out. FBI in January investigating whether Ilhan Omar married her brother. Great. Expand this to the campaign finance violations. All right. Now, here's where things get challenging. Moving on from Ilhan Omar. And getting into why it's going to be difficult to actually go after her for whether or not she was illegally paying this guy. Members of Congress have a new strategy for ethics investigations, stonewalling. The Office of Congressional Ethics does not have subpoena power, so lawmakers have increasingly decided that not cooperating is the better approach. This is from ProPublica. ProPublica is a nonprofit investigative news outlet, and they detest Donald Trump. I can't tell you how much nonsense they pump out about about the orange man being bad. To see this was actually kind of shocking. They say, congressional investigators wanted to talk. Rep. Rashida Tlaib, squad member, far-left Democrat, the freshman Democrat from Michigan, faced allegations that she improperly paid herself a salary from her campaign account, including a bulk payment of $15,500 after the election was over. That's around half the salary of many Americans. You know, I think most Americans are earning maybe like 37 to 40K. She paid herself $15,500 after the election was over, and they wanted to investigate whether that was true or not. Tlaib told reporters the payments were proper, but when the Office of Congressional Ethics, the House independent nonpartisan watchdog, asked to interview her, the congresswoman refused. So did her staffers who had been involved in the payments. And there you go. So look, you want to go after these people for breaking the law, enriching themselves? Well, what are you going to do about it? Because apparently these institutions have no real teeth. Outside of general corruption, I think it's fair to say that these progressives are liars. They are grifters. I do not trust them at all. Let me show you one more story, and then I'll throw some shade over at Bernie Sanders. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez's campaign may have illegally paid her boyfriend. February 28th, 2019. The story goes that there was a circuitous payment plan put in place with Saiket Chakrabarty. I think I'm getting it right. If I'm, you know, it's been a year, so I'll try to tell you the gist of the story. Basically, you have the campaign of Ocasio-Cortez. Then you have the consulting firm, a for-profit company that does a bunch of services for the campaign. That for-profit basically hires her boyfriend, and then he doesn't do any real work. That's what they're accusing. He's saying he did. But 2 months later, quits, gets two paychecks, and then moves to New York City to be with Omar. The general idea is that if the campaign is supposed to pay the LLC, you basically have one guy. It's all his money, but because the money can be legally originating from the campaign, but from him, the campaign can pay him and say it's for something else, and then he can hire her boyfriend who barely works for a couple months, and then all of a sudden moves to New York and quits that job. It stands to reason, or a lot of people think so, that this was just a way to funnel money illegally to her boyfriend so he could move in with her. I'm not saying it's true. I don't think it really went anywhere, but listen. I highlight this story and because of what we're seeing with Ilhan Omar and her affair. I'll point out there are a lot of people, establishment Democrats and conservatives, who would love to take them down and find any reason to dredge up something about them. They're facing political rivals from the moderate Democrats and the conservatives. It's a fair point. It is. However, they've also actually been fined. Like Ilhan Omar actually paid a fine. This is true. The FBI is actually looking into her. I think it's fair to just say these people, like many of the woke progressive left, are grifters. You know, I hate using that word. I really do. They'll accuse me of being a grifter because I have an opinion on things. But you don't see me, you know, claiming I'm going to fight for these injustices and against campaign finance stuff, but then using dark money schemes, setting up political action committees. They claim they're the good guys going to make all these great changes, but they enrich themselves. Bernie Sanders used to say the millionaires and the billionaires, because I'll tell you what. If you're worth $10 million, you're going to have undue influence on politics. I mean, relative to most people. While I can certainly respect that people who have earned wealth can use that as they see fit, I personally think we should have limits on campaign finance spending. And although we do have limits on donations per person, like you can't give more than $2,800, someone who's worth tens of millions of dollars can spread that money out across the board and promote certain ideas or give to PACs. So there are still, you know, there's loopholes for this. Bernie Sanders used to complain the millionaires and the billionaires were manipulating politics because they are, at least more so than the average person can. Then Bernie Sanders became a millionaire, and now he doesn't say millionaires and billionaires anymore. And apparently someone, I don't know if it's true, but somebody said on Twitter, like if you look at his Twitter, you can see the exact point when he stopped calling out the millionaires, and it coincides around the same time Bernie Sanders became a millionaire. Here's the way I explain it. Bernie is this guy who claims to be fighting this oppressive class, but he no longer calls out people who are worth $999 million because he has $1 million. That to me shows this guy doesn't actually care. So I'll tell you what, it is not difficult to point out that somebody who has $1 million has substantially less, you know, power than someone with $999 million. Just because Bernie became a millionaire doesn't mean he should stop calling them out. But that says to me, the reason he did is because he likes being the millionaire. He's the part of the 1% now, man. It's the first time in his life. He's older. He sold a book. His movement enriched him. So why call out? He's in the club, baby. Well, the funny thing about it is, you think if you got $1 million, you walk up to a guy who's worth $999 million, and you're like, we're millionaires, right? The guy's going to be like, well, I mean, you know, I'm basically a billionaire, but sure, you're a millionaire, buddy. It's a dramatic difference in power. The war doesn't mean anything. But of course, Bernie won't sit anymore, which says to me, he was standing outside. That there's the millionaires and billionaires club, right? First floor is a millionaires, second floor is a billionaires. And he's looking outside with all the people behind him, and he's looking in the window going, I want to be a millionaire, banging on the window. Well, then one day, somebody walks the front door, opens it up, and says, hey, Bernie, we're letting you into the millionaires club. But just don't badmouth us, okay? And Bernie's like, yeah, of course. Bernie runs in that first floor party. Now he's sipping wine and he's laughing. And now he turns around and all those people behind him were saying, Bernie, are you going to let us in? No. The billionaires upstairs, they're the problem. Bernie all of a sudden doesn't care about the millionaires. These are the people that he surrounds himself with. You think I'm going to trust that guy? Sorry, not going to happen. The squad has been embroiled in ongoing, you know, investigations. Look at this. The squad is being investigated for allegedly cheating its way into Congress from November. And this is a broader story about all of the different things that they have done with, you know, Ocasio-Cortez was apparently a board member or something on a PAC that was supporting her campaign. There are a bunch of different instances where they have repeatedly grazed the line at the very least. Now, if there were proper investigations, we might find that they've actually done things. As we can see with Rashida Tlaib, she's stonewalling. We can see Ilhan Omar did violate, you know, campaign finance law and had to pay a fine for it. But they repeatedly do this. Why? It's the same thing with Bernie Sanders refusing to call out millionaires today. Because he is one, man. They got the power. They don't care how they got it. And they ain't going to give it up. Now that they're in power, they will gloat and they will do whatever they can. They don't actually care about these causes. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez lost tons of jobs in New York by chasing out Amazon, then tried denying she had any involvement at all. Then when they opened a marketing office, she sat in a chair and gloated about how she saved the day. And people ate it up. Her followers were like, yes, you're right, AOC. She is just a grifter, saying what needs to be said to make it seem like she's doing something right. She might actually lose her seat. But all she cares about, in my opinion, is fame. Fame, narcissism, it's ego. It's what they're all doing. None of them actually care. They don't care about what is right. Rashida Tlaib said she wanted to impeach Trump before she even got in. When she was being, you know, brought, you know, right after she won election, she's like, we're going to impeach the mother effer, right? Then you want me to believe that she actually cared about the Ukraine scandal. No. These people are just saying what needs to be said to get the keys to the castle, to make the money. And that's funny because I've said in the past, changing my opinion on with new information, that I genuinely thought some of these progressives actually wanted to bring about change. I referred to Schumer, Pelosi, Nadler, those people as the keys to the castle Democrats, the people who just want to be let into the ivory tower so they can sit down and sip their fancy wine. Well, you know what? Shame on me, because I should have seen it for what it is. These people just want to be the ones in the ivory tower too, and they got to get rid of the other ones if they're going to do it. They found a path to power, and now they're going to take it. Do they actually care about you or me? For the most part, I would argue no. If that were the case, Ilhan Omar wouldn't be engaging in this kind of behavior. She wouldn't be cheating on people, having affairs, using, you know, campaign resources. Let me tell you something. Even if she has legitimate reasons to be paying for Tim Mynett to fly around with her, conflict of interest. You shouldn't be dating the people you're working with. I get it. It happens and you can do it. Sure, fine. My personal opinion. But if you're going to then give tons of money, hundreds of thousands of dollars, conflict of interest, you should avoid these things. But you know what? The big issue for me is they're in politics. They're supposed to be held to a higher standard. They're supposed to be the good guys fighting for the little guy to end the corruption. But in the end, they are the exact same. They're humans. And as I like to say, humans do human stuff. Humans say, hey, I got money. I want to use it. Why do I got to follow the rules? I'm special, they say. And that's what you end up getting. And it's often, no matter who you choose, that's what you get. It's why I can't stand politics. It's why I don't care to vote for anybody for the most part, because I know no matter who you pick, they're going to play the same games. Finding someone, a person of true integrity who wants to do right by everyone, is extremely difficult. Welcome to the political world. This is what we get. She lied the whole time. So let me just say this. It is a fact that Ilhan Omar is acting in corrupt and unethical ways. and I'll explain it to you. Because like I said, when I was, I don't know if I brought this up, but maybe I did. When I was first planning this segment, I said, is it unethical for somebody to cheat on their husband with a guy while they pay him hundreds of thousands of dollars and he cheats on his wife and then they lie about it to the press? Yeah, that's corrupt and unethical. I'll leave it there. I can't say I'm surprised. I'll see you on the next segment coming up at 6 p.m. YouTube.com/TimCastNews. It is a different channel. Thanks for hanging out. I'll see you there.